Hi there. Welcome to Weekly Singapore Stocks with Jonathan Tan. Whatever that is presented here solely my opinion. Hi.
If you like to trade, please consult your authorized broker. I am not your broker.
Enjoy the presentation ahead.
Good morning. Welcome to Weekly Singapore Stock with Jonathan. Today is 30th of October 2011. And now, the headline news. Police has confirmed that they received a missing animal report. Last seen was on the 3rd of October. So if you have seen this animal, please do not approach this animal because this animal has the tendency to bite. The last description, this animal was wearing a teddy bear that is brown in color. So therefore, do remember, please report to the nearest police if you have seen this animal and please do not go near this animal. Investigation have shown that this particular animal disappeared right after he spotted this in Singapore Straits Times. So investigation are still going on to see where has the bear this disappeared to. Alright, now further news. Europe saved Greece once again. So with countries or banks or anybody holding big massive Greece debt, they are forced, like it or not, to reduce half of their debt, 50% off. Okay, now Europe also had the funding, $1 trillion. They increased their funds to save the European Union. We'll see whether will that be enough. And the latest news right now just came out this afternoon is Qantas got grounded. Tiger Air flew, and now maybe Jetstar could be in trouble. But could this be good news for SIA? We'll see what will happen to the market moving forward. Now, one particular counter that you might want to be very careful is this particular counter called MF Global. The parent company of MF Global in Singapore. Massive sell down. Apparently, rumors is that they have some exposure to the European crisis. So there was a massive sell down. So therefore, do be careful if you have this particular counter. Okay? Now, this week, what else do you need to take note of? Basically, one word. Be very careful. Why? Because this week, even though end of October, most of the companies have reported their quarter reports, this week we have Ben Bernanke news. Tuesday, Wednesday, FOMC will have their report. And Wednesday, Ben Bernanke will come up with their report, monthly report statement again. And it is also the time of the month, whereby this Friday will be another non-farm payroll. So we'll see whether will there be any more jobs creation. Okay, so this ends the headline news. Alright, so what happened to the market? Well, basically, let's take a look. One word, the bulls are in control. The bears totally disappeared. Gone. Not a single glance. Not a single whiff. Not a single dust. Nothing. Just gone. In fact, if you take a look, S&P from the low since 3rd of October rally all the way up as high as 20%. It went up 20% in about a month. Very fantastic rally. Very hard to see this rally. In fact, previously, massive sell down, massive bear attack. Now it's massive bull attack fighting back. Okay, so over in here, let's take a look. If you take a look at the Fibonacci level, right about here, okay, oh, let me zoom in closer so you'll be able to see. Right now, even though this level is not very strong, but it's now at Fibonacci 78.6% acting as a resistance. Okay, now if you take a look, pullback, if we do have a pullback, if we do have a pullback, do watch out for a pullback, perhaps at about the 38.2, because the 38.2 will be about where the 20-day and the 50-day moving average will coincide. So therefore, very simple word. Okay, let me summarize the whole YouTube. You just don't have time to watch it. One very simple word: bulls is in control, and right now it is way overextended. Let me say again: if you're thinking about longing, you are gonna be really. You love danger, let's just put it this way. You will love danger. If you like to live life on the edge, yes, then go for bull. Enter long position right now. But right now, pullback is expected at any point of time. Because right now, market is extreme overbought. market has gone up for 1 month continuously and hasn't had a major pullback yet. So therefore, a pullback is expected. Okay, now let's see why. Over here, SPY expected a pullback any point of time, it should touch the 20-day moving average, because sooner or later any stock price will touch the 20-day moving average. The good news is 20-day moving average right now is sloping up. So that means if there's a pullback, the 20-day moving average or the 50-day moving average will act as a very good support. Now, why did market went up tremendously? Just one word, photocopy machine. US dollars came down tremendously and came down a lot since the 3rd of October. Right here. Ever since US dollar made a high of 3rd of October, US dollars collapsed all the way down, and the collapse is crazy. That means photocopy machine has been working non-stop like crazy. Okay, now do remember, right now US dollars is coming to a very very strong support. Okay, coming close. If US dollars break 2088 in UUP, it has never seen this low before. Okay, so that support $20.88 in UUP is what everyone is going to watch. And if that breaks, US dollars have never seen that low before. So it's massive photocopying. That's why US market rallied tremendously. Okay, now let's take a look at Hang Seng. Hang Seng is reaching the 100-day moving average acting as a resistance. Do take note, it's still sloping down, so it still can act as a resistance. Now, if by any chance it does break above, the next level to watch out for, it will be this very strong window, which is going to have a very hard time to break. Because that falling window is a prior support turn resistance. Notice the level, resistance, support, and it also will coincide with the 200-day moving average. So that window is going to be one very hard resistance to break in Hang Seng. Okay, now straight times. After the inverse head and shoulder, straight times broke higher. Let me draw the inverse head and shoulder right here. Broke the neckline for the inverse head and shoulder, rallied tremendously and continue to go higher. So right now, if straight time goes higher, right now is actually touching the 100-day moving average, and there is also a falling window just right above, right here and right here. Oops, and right here. So be very careful. Hang Seng, straight times is reaching overbought. Now let's pick a guess. Ever wonder how many counters in Singapore oversold versus overbought? Very simple number. Zero counter in Singapore oversold. Zero. But we have 63 counters in Singapore overbought. 63. So what does this tell you? Market is extreme overbought. Very seldom we see zero oversold, but it happens. So right now, if you're thinking about longing, you will love life on the edge. That means you love danger. Well, can it go higher? Always possible. The risk, but the risk and reward is not on your side. Okay, now let's take a look at banks. Banks. DBS highlighted on Charting Academy. Akan datang came. It broke through that resistance and flew higher on Thursday and Friday, as per highlighted in the chartingacademy.com website. Right now, no signal, too long, no signal for reversal yet. In fact, DBS is the strongest bank, because OCBC on Friday could only manage a doji, whereas UOB managed a spinning top look-alike candle. Okay, it's a black candle. Okay, now, in terms of commodities, Noble Group touches the 100-day moving average acting as a resistance. Sakari, do be very careful. Okay, because on Sakari on Friday, it is near the 100 and 200 day moving average right here. But what I'm not comfortable is the high volume on Sakari on Friday, and the high volume comes with upper shadow. That means there is a possible resistance in Sakari being seen. Okay, so do be careful. If you're long position Sakari, do put a trailing stop. Okay, now in terms of marines. Marines, do take note, Costco and Yang Zijiang didn't participate much in this rally upside. Okay, in this rally upside, didn't participate a lot compared to Keppel Corp, compared to Sembcorp or Sembmarine. Okay, Sembmarine right now is also touching the 100-day moving average. Right now, no energy. But one particular counter, NOL, it is totally restless. No energy to go higher, also no energy to go down lower. So, no NOL. I think the coming out with quarter report, maybe that will be a spark for it to go up or down. But as of now, there is no direction in NOL at this moment. So, if you want to take a look, NOL right now at this moment is actually forming a Bollinger squeeze. Okay, let's take a look. Does the weekly chart has a Bollinger squeeze? No, weekly chart do not have. So it is only appearing in the daily chart, the Bollinger squeeze. Okay, so do take note. Now, plantations. In terms of plantations, Wilma broke. Let me just put it this way. It's hard to imagine, but Wilma broke through these congestion levels to go higher. It broke the 100-day, it broke the 200-day to go higher. Amazing. This bull run is extremely amazing. Okay, now properties in terms of city development cleared. City development on Friday cleared the 200-day moving average, cleared. Apart from that, CapitaLand haven't cleared, but it cleared the 100-day. FNN broke through the congestion, went up the high, and is now at that resistance right here. Okay, this previously the rounding top resistance, FNN is reaching that rounding top resistance. In fact, a lot of counters right now rallied. Okay, a lot of counters right now rallied. In fact, the casino, the Genting Singapore, also rallied. SIA broke down from, SIA broke down from the bear flag, never broke down from the major support of that bear flag, rallied. Oh, this run is crazy. Okay, this bull run is crazy. Now, let's just put it this way, let me resummarize. Okay, market has went up tremendously, market is extremely overbought. If you want to enter long positions, that means you're taking a very high risk. If you're able to accept that risk, then you take the risk. Okay, but right now market extremely overbought, pullback is expected at any point of time. When? We don't know, but it's any point of time. Okay, but because this strong bull run went up so much, so high, that means there's very high probability it will form a higher low. So that means if it's a higher low, that means short term uptrend will be starting. So that means if the higher low comes in, perhaps at the 20-day moving average or the 50-day or the Fibonacci support, that means if there's a bullish reversal signal, there's opportunity to enter on a long position. Okay, so do watch out for that. And if you'd like to find out more, haven't been posting much because there's really nothing much to share about in the stock market. Basically, right now it's just watching. But if you'd like to find out more, do share and go to chartingacademy.com, and remember, do share this YouTube and Chartered Academy with all your friends. And good news is, you may have known, Dream First 8 is up and running. So do go to Dream First 8 and watch the video. And remember, before you start off the video and YouTube, read the how-to section. Find out how to make full use of this particular website. Alright, so see you next week and be safe in your trading. Thank you. Good morning, welcome to Weekly Singapore Stock with Jonathan. Today is 30th of October 2011 and now the headline news. Well, police has confirmed that they have received a missing animal report, and upon investigation they have found out that this animal has been missing since 3rd of October 2011. The last description that was that it was wearing some teddy bear clothing, it's brown in color. So if you have a lookout and you spot this animal, please be careful because they have a tendency to bite. Okay, and further news, the this week news, Europe has saved Greece once again with banks they are holding more than